Hey y'all, put your gloves on. Let's tie-dye today. So, I got a comment. I'm going to take a stab at the pronunciation. Black Magic 4. Thanks for the comment. Thanks for watching. Who stated, stuff a shirt in a jar, mix the soda ash with the dye powder, and you'll have a lot of fun effects. So, I was definitely answered excitedly, cool. But I didn't ask for more information. I kind of just let it stay there because I wanted to play. So, I have two soup takeout containers. Once you use a container with tie-dye, it forever belongs with your tie-dye. Do not mix it back into your consumables. So, this is why these are takeout containers. I can use them for water. I can use them for anything. But these now are forever part of my studio. Just remember that. You don't mix and match. Well, another thing too. I have done silk tie-dye. And you microwave silk. It's absolutely stunning. But you don't mix and match your edibles. Do not microwave your tie-dye in the same microwave you microwave your food in. There's your PSA today from Miss Tish, okay? So, I have my soda ash. I'm using tea leaves, natural fiber, procyon dye because it's a mix of a lot. It's going to break it down into a lot of components, and I want to see that. And then I'm also using, Kingfisher. Which is going to break down into a lot of different components, which I think will be a nice breakdown in color. I took this is my logic. This is my L-O-J-I-K. You ready? For a 12-ounce squirt bottle of dye, takes, depending on the dye strength, so most of the dyes I have, like this coral pink, there's no asterisk beside it, which means that it's 2 teaspoons per 8 fluid ounces. So my containers are 12 ounces, so 2 and 3. So 3 teaspoons per 12 ounce of that manufacturer's recommendations. So then I thought, okay, if I have a 12 ounce squirt bottle and I'm going to tie-dye, say, a crinkle, because this will be a crinkle as opposed to a spiral, depending on the amount of colors that I use, say I'm going to use 2 colors and do front and back, I'm going to use probably a total of 8 ounces. So we'll say 4 ounces per side. So we break that down, and 4 ounces is 1 teaspoon. Okay, follow me where I'm going. So, Black Magic 4 said to mix the soda ash and the dye powder together, it will stretch it further. And I understand why now, because of the granules of the soda ash mixed with the dye powder, it flows. It doesn't clump. It flows a lot nicer. So I did 1 teaspoon of soda ash and 1/2 teaspoon of the dye powder, because we're going to juice up that dye powder by adding even more soda ash to it. Okay, we're amping it up. So I'm going to go with 1/2 teaspoon dye powder, 1 teaspoon soda ash in the bottle. So I got tea leaf in this little, just so I can, tap it out. And then I got some extra that I'm going to throw in there too. Now, Black Magic 4 said also put some soda ash and dye in the bottom of your container and then start squishing your t-shirt down in there. So I'm going to prep this one with some soda ash. I'm just eyeballing it here, okay? I'm gonna do it both. We're gonna activate them both pretty heavy. But the tea leaves, I'm going to add just a little bit extra in the bottom to try that. And then for this one, as I squish the t-shirt in, I'm gonna squish some, I'm gonna zhuzh it with the kingfisher, squish some more in, zhuzh it. Like, editor's note, I didn't even listen to myself talk. I just had a bunch of ideas going. I was really excited wanting to share them with you, so don't pay attention to exactly what I said. We're just gonna make it up as we go. This, right? Just sprinkle it as I'm pushing it down. Look, I knocked a bottle over and tried to grab it. Look what I did. Wear your gloves, kids. That's the second PSA. Mama's heavy with the advice today. So, here's our tea leaves. Already, we're gonna start in the bottom. And then here's our, we're gonna amp it up. Got this one ready. And we're gonna have to have our hot water. And we're gonna have to have our t-shirt. Are we ready? Okay, so I've got my t-shirt. And like always, soaked in a soda ash water solution. 20 minutes or more, spun out in the washing machine until damp, like we always do. I got these t-shirts. My friend Sandra called me and she said, hey, found a bunch of t-shirts for $1. They were Gildan, but here's the label printed here on the shirt. And then they just did like a heat press of a Gildan label on top. And when you wash them, they peel off. But this is my experiment shirt, so I don't care. And they're my size, so if I mess them up, I'm going to wear them. I don't care. So I'm going to start with the hem as opposed to like just wadding it up this way. I'm going to start with the hem and just start to feed it from the hem up towards the collar into the container. I want to move that so I don't knock it over. So this is the kingfisher. So we got a little bit on the bottom, and then I'm gonna put the shirt in there. You're supposed to pack it in real tight, and then I'm gonna sprinkle some kingfisher in there, and then I'm gonna squish the shirt down in there. You feel me, right?
Editor's note, I started this morning with no coffee. Don't judge me.
And you're supposed to squish it super tight. It's going to expand when you pour hot water on it, obviously. So I'm just squishing it down in there best I can, tight as I can. And then I'm going to hit the rest of that kingfisher. Okay, so we got, you know, a little tie-dye t-shirt parfait going on here. Yeah. So we did this one, and I'm going to do the same, but in the bottom of this is no extra dye. It's just the soda ash. And then I think I said it backwards earlier, how I was going to pour it and mix and pour it and mix. So I did that on this one and can't edit it out now. So yeah, you're here with me live, kids. And then this one I'm going to do the same. I'm going to start with the hem, and I'm just going to mush this shirt in here really tight. Tight as I can. This is not strong enough for me to push on. All right, and I'm just gonna take this kingfisher soda ash.
Apparently kingfisher is my new favorite word.
And I'm gonna put it on the whole top, just like that. Let it work its way through with the hot water. So we've got a parfait and a sundae. Okay, now let's get the hot water. Okay, got the kettle. And I'm just gonna fill it up slowly. I'm gonna alternate between the two. Oh, I need to hold it from the other side. Be nice to you. And that's why right there, I want it to stay a little packed. It's kind of fun to watch it roll down the side. That's what, this one is not packed as tight. We're already near the bottom. And we are full. It's starting to pool in the bottom of this container now. And you can see it's not soaking in, it's pooling up here. Well, not quite pooling up in here yet. I don't know how much to pour in here. I could have asked. And I'm sure Black Magic would have told me, blah, blah, blah. Oh, I hope that sticker doesn't, like, well, these shirts aren't for sale. I'm sure Black Magic 4 would have told me specific everything, but I think it's fun to play. And I'm going to let these sit in this container. Hey, that's hot. Okay. I'm going to let these completely cool. I'm going to guess, just because they're so packed in there, into the core, I'm going to go at least an hour. I got some things I gotta do, so we'll be back in about an hour. Okay, it's been an hour. Oh, these are still quite warm. And it's cool in here. We got full saturation, you can see. Not any side is sitting with like a dry pocket. So, yep, and well. We're going to let it set. Let's give it another hour. It'll go by real quick for you, I promise. Okay. These are not completely cool. This is hour 3. It could go longer. I've had my shower. I'm going to go have lunch with my bestie. We're going to go back for hour 4. Okay. Okay, it's been roughly 4 hours since I started this. I've had my shower, went out and had lunch with my bestie, and we went to Pam's Farmer's Restaurant. It's on Western Boulevard in Raleigh. I had fried bologna, pickled beets, and collards because I'm 80 years old, and it was amazing. I'm not mad about any of that lunch I had today. So now, let's see if I'm mad about this. Let's go rinse it out. Oh my God. So those seconds, Gildan's, I'm not impressed, but you know I didn't stop there because I wanted to try multiple colors on a quality shirt. Okay, look. First. This is the tea leaves. I got it right this time. So, mixing it. Look how mottled. Look how those colors broke out. Because the tea leaf is made up of several different shades to make this tea leaf in golds and greens and browns. And it's beautiful and it's subtle. It actually turned out better than I thought because of this shirt. This shirt, these are the cheapy Gildan ones. They feel oily. I don't know if there's a special coating of some sort on them, but they have a feel to them. And they're wicked soft, but it actually held the color a lot better. Look how that broke out. This is one color, tea leaves. And look how it broke out across there from these golds and browns into the grays. Look how dark. This is beautiful. And this is mixing the tea leaf with the soda ash, mixing it up in the bottle, and then alternating, right? And this is the kingfisher. I got it right. And the kingfisher. Look at this beautiful. Almost like it almost made like a collar here and then broke out. That's the fun of doing the crinkles and things like that, because you don't know what's gonna happen until you wash it out, right? But look how this color broke out. So we pushed it in from the hem to the collar, and then we put all of the kingfisher on the top and then just let it run down. And so it just kept lightening up all the way through the fabric. Absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I'll wear this. This is my size. I'll wear this. Now we gotta talk about this. Okay. Oh my gosh. This is so... Oh, I'm just not having... This is so vibrant. Okay, this is the azure blue and the celadon and the parakeet. This is more on brand for me. This is not subtle. This is not a smooth contrast. This is just loud and blotchy and vibrant. This was the second set of shirts that I did. It's a higher quality shirt. I did not break down the color by mixing it with the soda ash. I just put spoonfuls of the dye powder directly and then sprinkled some soda ash. So this is more vibrant, more... Gosh, look at that. Oh, this is my size too. But wait! This is the fire red and the soft orange and the lemon yellow. Look. Then this fire red broke out into, will it pick it up, into hot pink? Do you see that hot pink there? And that's what that fire red, because it's so deep. It just, oh my gosh. Absolutely stunning. This isn't my size. But, look what we did today. We did an experiment and we made art. So somebody tell me, what's this called? Like, I know it's a hot water immersion, but it's in a bucket. It's in a container. So is it still hot water immersion in a bucket? What's this called? Because I like this and I want to keep doing this. And now that I have compared mixing the dye with the soda ash and then just putting the dye directly on the fabric, two different kinds of fabric, it's stellar. Absolutely stellar. Can't stop, won't stop. And if you like these kind of videos, please like and subscribe. I'll make sure I put it in a playlist where it's easier for you to find. My channel's loaded with content. Jewelry, tie-dye, crocheting, and a lot of other things. And if you like the designs that I do, and that I do tutorials on, scooch on over to my Etsy store. You'll find these and a lot more. Mark your favorite today. And remember, be peaceful. Be kind. It's important. Try something new today. And then tell me about it. Who knows? You might like it. I'll talk to you soon.